This is a University of Sheffield Health Service screencast.
Welcome to this screencast on the contraceptive method called the Intrauterine System. We'll cover what it is, how it works, how effective it is, its advantages, and its disadvantages. The Intrauterine System is a member of a group called the Long Acting Reversible Contraceptives, or LARCs for short. We'll cover the general features of LARCs first, and then go on to talk specifically about the intrauterine system thereafter.
There are four different types of long-acting reversible contraceptives. The first is a copper intrauterine device, called IUD, or copper coil. Then there is the intrauterine system, or IUS. Thirdly, there are contraceptive injections. And lastly, there is the contraceptive implant. LARCs are suited for women who want contraception without having to remember to take it daily, or at the time of intercourse. Their effects are also reversible, so there's no long-term effect on your fertility. It has been found that women who use LARCs have less unwanted pregnancies than those who use the pill, because the pill is only 99% effective if it's used perfectly. LARCs are particularly suited to those women who have a body mass index, or BMI, over 30, have diabetes or migraines with or without aura, and those who can't take estrogen-containing contraceptives. It should be remembered that LARCs do not provide protection against sexually transmitted infections, so use a condom in addition if you think you are at risk. The intrauterine system is a small plastic device that's fitted in the uterus. It slowly releases progesterone. It acts primarily by preventing implantation of the fertilized egg.
Studies show that the intrauterine system is more than 99% effective.
The advantages of the intrauterine system is that it gives immediate contraceptive protection if it's inserted within the first 7 days of a period. If not, condoms or abstinence is needed for the week after insertion. It's also effective for 5 years. Once it's removed, fertility returns back to its previous levels immediately.
The potential disadvantages are as follows. It's likely that you'll feel discomfort during and after the insertion. There is also a small risk of the uterus being punctured or perforated during the procedure. Irregular vaginal bleeding and spotting is common in the first 6 months of use, but by 1 year, most women either don't have a period or have very infrequent bleeds. There is a higher risk of pelvic infection in the first 20 days following insertion, but this falls back down to your background level thereafter. If your underlying risk of catching an STI is high, and hence your chance of developing a pelvic infection, you should consider using condoms in addition to the IUS. You can discuss this with your doctor further. Expulsion of the device, or when it's pushed out of the uterus, can occur in up to 1 in 20 women. This happens mostly in the first year of use, and especially during the first 3 months after insertion. You'll be given instructions on how you can check for yourself that the device is still in place. If the IUS fails, there is a risk that the resulting pregnancy may implant outside of the uterus, called an ectopic pregnancy. However, this risk is less than if no contraception was used at all. It is uncommon for women to discontinue the IUS due to hormonal side effects. For further information and to view the reference material used, please note the following. You can only view these if you've enabled the annotations function. This is the end of the screencast on the intrauterine system.